You boo-boo, you teed, you turned down, you thirsty, you boo-boo,
This video is called Cutting You Off to Grow Closer. If you know Kendrick Lamar, that's one of my old-time favorite artists, and he made a song basically about cutting people out of your life who just are not enhancing it at any means. They are detrimental to you, whether it's be they're talking crap about other people, whether it's they have no real goals in their life, they're just hindering your growth, and you need to cut off those people, not because you hate them or you wish them ill. It's more so you need to focus on you, and you need to get to where you want to get in life, and they're just not helping you get there. I'm in this video because in the past, let's say, 5 years, I've been cutting people out of my life. Not necessarily the same as cutting you off to grow closer, but more so it's just that they didn't fit in my life. Whether they were hindering me, whether it was they had no real goals in life, whether it was they were detrimental and they just wished me ill. Whatever the case was, there's a lot of people who I had to be with them for a season, and then once that season ended, I needed them to no longer be in my life. It's hard because you go and you have genuine feelings for the person, not necessarily intimate feelings, but more so, you know, this was your person, this was your friend, this is your confidant, or whatever the case may be, and they're no longer that. So you have to readjust yourself to detox from that relationship, but also to move on and be a better person. So for me, how I dealt with that was basically, I'm different because when it comes to me, I don't really do the whole breakup thing or closure. I'm more of, if I don't hit you up no more, you figure I'm not messing with you no more. If I don't call you, if I don't go over your house, if we're not interacting, that basically should let you know you no longer need access to me. And that's how it worked for me. Now that I'm older, I'm starting to use my big girl words and say, you know, this is the reason why I can't really mess with you no more. This is the reason why I really just can't kick it with you no more, because you're hindering me. You are either detrimental, you're slighting me, you're either taking away from my progress, you're either stunting my growth, or whatever the case may be. I have to let you know so you're not out of the loop or think that it's just a break, or when I'm like, no, this is a forever thing. Like, it's done. Totally done. Don't call me no more. Don't come over. I want nothing to do with you. So, yeah, and it's like I said, it's hard because you grow to have feelings for the person. And it's not necessarily intimate, like this is my boyfriend or whatever. This is my friend. You know, we kick this together. It's harder the longer the relationship is, the deeper it is, the more vulnerable you have been with the person. It's harder, but you have to, because there's some people, they just aren't going to fulfill you the way they used to. And to dumb yourself down or to slow the process down just to say that you still kick it with the person is not benefiting the relationship, because it's just heavy on your shoulders and you don't want to go around a person and you just like, ugh, can't stand being around this person, but you have to fake the funk. And for me, I do not have a poker face. My feelings tell it before I do. My mouth will say another thing, but my face will tell something totally different. So I can't even fake the funk if I don't like you like that. And like I said, it's a hard process, but it needs to be done. There have been multiple people I cut off from my life, whether it be family, whether it be friends, whether it be childhood friends, whether high school friends, college friends. It is what it is. And there's some people I've gained. Once you cut off, you do also gain. I've gained really good friends. I gained my mentor at a job that I hated, but we ended up being really good friends. And you know, that's just life. Not too many people are going to be there permanently, and you need to learn the lessons that come with the person and let it go when it's time to let it go. But it doesn't necessarily mean there's something wrong with you, and it may not even be something wrong with the person. It's just that that season has ended, and learn what you can from that person and move on. It's not always a negative thing, but it's not always a positive thing. Relationships are meant for you to learn about yourself and learn whatever you can from that person. So yeah. If you like this video, comment below. Tell me about you. Tell me if you had to cut people off your life and how did you do that? Was it a positive experience, a negative experience? How do you even go about canceling a person? Do you, like, tell them, or do you just like, oh, you know, we just don't talk no more, and I just haven't let that person know? Rate, comment, subscribe, share, and you can find me in all things social media. I'm out.
Every time you come around, you be hollering at whoop-de-whoop, blah say blah, he say she say, so tell him shut the fuck up. Tell him shut the fuck up. Yeah, bitch, you boo-boo, you tea, you turn down, you thirsty. Tell him shut the fuck up. Tell him shut the fuck up. Yeah, nigga, you boo-boo, you tea, you turn down, you thirsty, you thirsty. You boo-boo, you tea, you turn down, you boo-boo, you tea. You boo-boo, you turn down, you thirsty. You tea, you boo-boo, you turn down. You boo-boo, you tea, you turn down. You weak, you weak, your bitch weak.